Hey, I'm Amir, and today you're going to find out what happens to your stuff when you throw it in a magical place called Away.
Wow!
But have you ever wondered exactly where your stuff goes when you throw it away? Probably not. I mean, why should you? You've already done your job sorting through your waste. Isn't it someone else's problem now? Let's dig a little deeper and get out of this out of sight, out of mind mentality, because Away is actually a lot closer than you think. If your waste isn't sent to an Asian country, it ends up here, in one of the active landfills in the US. So what exactly is a landfill? It's pretty simple. Cities pay a company to dig a hole in the ground, toss in the stuff we want to forget, and then put a cover on it so we never have to look at it again. Take this for example. This is the Puente Hills Landfill, just a 10-minute drive from West Covina, California. It's 500 feet tall and covers 700 acres of land. It's the biggest landfill in the US. To put in perspective, it's taller than the Statue of Liberty and covers as much space as 530 American football fields. So what actually happens to your stuff when it ends up in one of these landfills? Well, not much really. It just kind of sits there, decaying itself and everything around it for a while. But the landfills themselves, that's a different story. One big problem with landfills is they produce this toxic liquid called leachate.
It's leachate.
Leachate is basically all the nasty liquids that collect from all the stuff in the landfill. Like, you know when you take out the trash and it's got this sort of liquidy stuff at the bottom of the bag? It's kind of like that. But in a landfill, leachate is made of more than just pasta sauce mixed with soda. We're talking paint, pesticides, bleach, nail polish, medicine, battery acid, you know, the wholesome stuff. With tons and tons of garbage stacked on top of itself, all of the liquid waste oozes down and becomes a slimy cocktail of toxic chemicals. What are companies doing to make sure that the chemicals stay in the landfill? Engineers have designed liners and systems to collect the leachate, but the problem is, the liners can be punctured. And if the chemicals don't leak out, wildlife can get into the landfill and cause all kinds of problems. One time, hundreds of gophers and squirrels were killed to prevent them from digging holes and potentially leaking toxic chemicals into the San Francisco Bay. Let's have a moment of silence for the fallen. Once a landfill is full, companies are required to continue monitoring the groundwater and repairing leaks for 30 years. But after the post-closure period, their responsibility ends, and it's up to the public to clean up the mess. So if you think about it, we aren't paying landfill companies to dispose of our trash. We're paying them to turn it into future public health hazards that we'll end up footing the bill for. There are over 2,000 active landfills in the US, but with the average American throwing out about 4.5 pounds of garbage a day, running out of space is a real threat. Which means we'll either have to open up more landfills or throw more stuff away to other countries. Those solutions smell like a steaming pile of crap to me. So what can you do? Well, you can reduce your waste by choosing products that have a longer lifespan. Things can be reused and repaired, like the good old days before everything was single use. And you can also choose to support companies that ethically source the production of their stuff and don't use excess plastic packaging. With 79% of plastics ending up in a landfill or the environment, more plastic is the last thing this planet needs. What are your ideas for reducing waste on a systemic level? How can we design a future where we stop waste before it's created? Let us know in the comments below. If you like this video, hit like and subscribe.